This is Alistair Weaver for Edmunds Inside Line with the highlights of this year's Detroit Auto Show. Now, after the abject misery of 2009, most manufacturers are back with some great new products and an optimistic vibe. Most manufacturers, that is. But not all. Ford's been full of good news stories of late, and that optimistic mood's continued here in Detroit. I mean, just look at the confidence of this stand. This is their show star, the new Focus, a car with global aspirations that hits the US in early 2011. Ford says it's all about downsizing size, but not aspirations. And when you take a look at it, it's hard not to agree. And there's also some good news for the US taxpayer. GM showed off some really exciting concepts. This is the GMC Granite, an attempt to take the GMC brand to the trendy young urbanites. We really like it, and we hope it's destined for production. Buick showed us the Regal GS. Now, they say it's only a concept, but it's really little more than a rebadged version of the European Opel Insignia. Not that that's necessarily a bad thing. Caddy showed us a great new luxury sedan concept called the STX, and it was hard not to fall in love with the CTS-V Coupe. Complete with a 562 horsepower engine, it'll do 0 to 60 in just 3.9 seconds. I, for one, can't wait to drive it. And look, even the Chevy Avio's starting to look appealing. This is the RS concept version that might yet prove an unlikely hot hatch hero. But what of the third member of the Detroit Big Three? Well, this is a Chrysler stand and they're showing nothing. This rebadged Lancia Delta is such a half-hearted effort, it's not even mentioned in the press pack. Extraordinary. Now, Detroit in January might seem like an unlikely time and place to launch a car without doors or even a roof, but this Beachcomber concept previews the new Mini SUV, and it might even make production. It also shows a continued commitment to the Europeans to the Detroit show. Mercedes also showed off a cabriolet here, this time based on the E-Class, while Audi and BMW looked ahead to an electric future with the e-tron and the concept Active E. Volkswagen, meanwhile, showed us a hybrid coupe concept, which unfortunately is a bit dull. And not surprisingly, our friends from the Far East were also pointing the way to an electric future. This is the production version of the CR-Z, Honda's sporty designer hybrid. And Toyota showed us the FTCH concept, which could be the first of 8 new hybrids from Toyota to be launched over the next 3 years. This has been another fascinating show, but you still get the impression that it's still very much an industry in transition, that the landscape at the 2011 Detroit Auto Show might look very different.